In this video example, I am going to show you how to use the TI-83 calculator to create a histogram and box plot. So for example, a university's Student Government Association often collects data on the average cost of textbooks. The data below represents a random sample of 9 students' textbook costs for the fall semester. We're going to construct a histogram and a box plot using our TI-83 calculator. To create a histogram as well as a box plot, first you'll need to enter the data. And in order to enter the data, we're first going to press the stat key and select number 1 for edit. I'm going to enter the data into L1, but you can enter the data into any of the lists. So first I want to enter in the first observation, which was 725. After entering in the observation, you'll want to press the enter key. And then you'll enter in the remaining observations. So 679, 730, and so forth. And again, make sure you press enter after entering each observation. If by chance you made a mistake, you can simply use the up or down arrow key and go to the specific observation, and you can press delete, or you can simply type over the observation. So you can press delete and it'll completely delete the observation, or you can just type over it. So since I deleted it, let me put it back into the list. And again, I'm going to press enter. Once all of the data is entered into the list, in order to access the histogram as well as the box plot, you're going to press the second key and then select the Y equals button so you can access stats plot. You'll want to then turn the plot on. So I'll select number 1 and turn the plot on by simply pressing enter on the on function. Then using the down arrow key, I'm going to go to type, and you'll see that the histogram is the third option. And in order to get there, you're going to use the right arrow key. Press enter, so now that you have the histogram highlighted. You'll use the down arrow key to enter your list. I entered my information in L1. If by chance you entered your information into a different list, you can change your list by using the second key and selecting either 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, or 6 to enter your list, because the lists are located in yellow above the numbers 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, and 6. So again, mine is in L1, so I'm going to keep it here. And then I'm going to press the zoom button and select number 9 for zoom stat. You can just type in 9 or you can scroll down. And there you see our histogram. To construct a box plot, we'll return to the stats plots function. So we'll press the second key and then the Y equals button and select number 1. Since the plot is already on, we won't need to do that again. We'll use the down arrow key to go to type, and then use the right arrow key to access the box plot, which is the 5th graph. Again, we'll press enter so that we can highlight the box plot. And then again, we'll enter our list. And in this example, the data is already in L1, so I don't need to change my list. I will then press the zoom button, and then again, number 9 for zoom stat, and you can see the box plot.